Let's start with the definition of power. Power is defined as the rate that energy is transferred. To help you appreciate this definition, consider a man going up a flight of stairs. For the man to get to the top of the stairs, he must increase his gravitational potential energy by mgh. Let's say that the man has a mass of 60 kilograms and the height of the stairs is 3 meters, then the man needs 1,764 joules of energy to reach the top of the stairs. The rate that the man obtains this amount of energy is power. We can calculate the average power by the change in energy divided by the change in time, or it can be described as the amount of energy transferred in time delta t. Because work is, by definition, a transfer of energy, this equation is also commonly written as work divided by delta t. The SI unit for power is a watt, where a watt is a joule per second. Another common unit for power is horsepower, where one horsepower is equal to 746 watts. So going back to the man climbing the stairs, regardless of how long it takes the man to climb the stairs, the fact that he needs 1,764 joules of energy is fixed. The variable is the time period it takes him to acquire this energy, or in other words, the power associated with his climb. If he walks up the stairs in 10 seconds, then the power associated with this is 1,764 joules divided by 10 seconds, or 176.4 watts. But if he runs up the stairs in 4 seconds, then the power associated with this is 441 watts. Now let's look a little more deeply at the energy picture of this event. The man obtains the energy he needs to climb the stairs from the food that he has consumed. In addition to converting 1,764 joules of food energy to potential energy, he is also generating quite a lot of heat. So he actually must burn quite a bit more food energy than just 1,764 joules to get to the top of the stairs. How much more energy he must burn is what efficiency is all about. We are often interested in the efficiency of a device to generate or to use energy. To explain efficiency, let's consider the power and efficiency of a light bulb. To produce light, the light bulb will use a certain amount of power. Some of this power will go into the emitted light of the bulb, which is the intended purpose of the light bulb, so I've called it useful power, and some of it will go into heat, which is not the intended purpose of the light bulb, though it's unavoidable, so I've called it wasted power. As you might guess, the total power used by the light bulb equals the useful power plus the wasted power. The efficiency of the light bulb describes how much of the power is useful and how much is wasted. The equation for percent efficiency is the ratio of the useful power to the total power times 100%. To demonstrate the use of this equation, let's consider a 100-watt incandescent light bulb. As a general rule, the power rating of a device, like a light bulb, is the total power that it typically uses. Incandescent light bulbs have very low efficiencies, so let's say that the 100-watt light bulb is 2% efficient. Using the efficiency equation, we can solve for the useful power, and plugging in values, we find that the light bulb produces 2 watts of light. We can also use the equation relating the three categories of power to solve for the wasted power. And so we see that the light bulb emits 98 watts of heat. The last thing I'd like to mention is that the equations related to efficiency can also be written in terms of energy. For instance, starting with the efficiency equation, each term can be replaced with energy divided by time, and then the delta t's cancel. So we wind up with the original efficiency equation, but in terms of energy instead of power. Based on that, here's the previous slide for the light bulb, but now everything is written in terms of energy rather than power. And so that brings us to the end of this video. See you next time.